Hey viewers, how's it going? Well, I decided it's time to go back to some Pikmin and just ramble on about anything that my mind can think of. I don't know. Because, like, this is all an experiment, and I like experimenting. But, you know, I should probably move on to a different subject, because, you know, explaining what I explained in the last part is probably nothing new, you know, it's probably not all that interesting. But that's okay. Point is, how are you? I don't know. I was, to be honest, I was just recording Pikmin. I recorded all of it, actually, so I have an idea of, like, how many parts we got left. But that's not the point. The point is I did some playing around with the settings and the color and everything. So hopefully it looks a lot better. You know, it looks a little bit more crisp, high quality. I don't know. I hope all of you can agree with me on that. It looks better in my opinion. But what do I know, right? All I do is just work on the videos and stuff like that. But you know, it's all good. Anyways, so stuff. Oh man, I don't even know what to talk about. I'm distracted. I was looking for my phone and then I realized it's probably like not where I'm looking, or it's like right here. I don't know. I was gonna take a looky-loo if I had any notifications, and I don't. Apparently I'm not popular with my friends, at least not enough to have them message me in the middle of a part. Because wouldn't that be a trip? No, one of these days, I think it'll happen, but I guess that's irrelevant at the time being. Anyways, it don't matter. It really doesn't. It's late at night. It's like 10 p.m., which for me, it's like 12 o'clock in the afternoon. Because I'm on a completely different schedule than normal people. Because, you know, who cares about being normal? I work nights, alright? I don't need to put up with this bull honky. I don't know. I feel like I swear a lot. Like, I don't know if it's been my job or if it's been, like, just, things. Because, I mean, like, in parts, I feel like, you know, I have this general persona, which is, like, at the first, it was always trying not to, like, swear a whole bunch. Because, you know, I wanted to have some semblance of class, but, you know, there are times when that really screwed me over, and it's like, fuck, why don't I swear? But now it's like, I feel like I've been swearing a lot, like every other sentence. I probably haven't, but it feels like that, you know? So it's like, I feel like I need to tone it back, you know? Like, I gotta find that perfect balance. Because it's not like I need to. It's not like I'm hanging around with my friend's kids, who affectionately consider me their uncle, so it's not like I have little kids. But you know, one day I might be hanging around with my nieces and nephews, and it's like, oh, I can't pull that kind of stuff. You know, I don't want to like teach them their first bat like curse words, because that's not something that my friend really wants to deal with. That would be terrible. You know, and like in public, you know, you gotta be careful, but like my job, no one cares. Everyone does it. It's that kind of job. But either way, you know, it's like, I feel like I need to tone it back a bit, except in my videos. Like probably here, I could probably try to up the ante, you know, I don't really have to worry too much. There's not really anything at stake. Hell, you guys are probably like, Gildem, why don't you swear more? And it's like, just because I was brainwashed when I was really young by my mom not to do it. And, you know, I guess that kind of transferred over to my persona. But either way, it's like, I don't swear a whole lot. And, but I have been lately, so I don't know. I guess that habit broke, and it's like, I've just been used to swearing so much, so it's weird. But, you know, whatever. Swearing, not swearing, I guess it's irrelevant. What was I going to talk about? There was something really specific I was going to bring up during this session, because I was like, man, you know what would be a good rambling topic? Thing one. I don't know. I've been playing a lot of games lately for my PlayStation, like Final Fantasy 15 and Pokemon and World of Final Fantasy, and I have some ideas for like the future of what I want to do for this channel Let's Plays. I don't think I'm going to do 15, because, you know, 15 is a good game, in my opinion. Plot-wise, not so much, but, like, you know, gameplay, the side missions, all that's the exploration was, like, fantastic. I mean, it's the exact opposite of 13. And I could rant all day. I think I brought that up last time, and I was gonna, like, talk about that more, but I have, like, this huge love for the Final Fantasy series. Like, I grew up on that shit, and I enjoy it to no end, or at least some of the installments. Others, not so much. Like, 13 was the one definitive title that almost made me swear off the whole entire series and Square Enix altogether, because it was such a betrayal to my childhood, you know? And I feel like everyone goes through that at least once, you know? You have, like, this fond, nostalgic game that you think of fondly, and it's part of a series, and you're like, oh man, the series is fantastic. But you're probably referring to this one title in the series. But regardless, it's like, because this one title was good, it's like, you kind of overlook the flaws of the other titles, so they're all good, you know? But 13 was just so bad, it just kind of spoiled the bunch, except for 7 and 6 and 9. 9 was pretty good. Although I played it last year, and I did like pretty much everything you can do except for the whole Excalibur 2. Which, if you don't know, apparently in Final Fantasy 9, if you speedrun it and you beat it, or you get to the end in about like 12 hours, you get like the best sword in the entire game, which I guess it's the best weapon. It's like super overpowered. It's insane. It has like some pretty good abilities, but nothing that you'll miss out on because other weapons have them. But that's besides the point. The point is, it's a really good weapon, but you have to beat the game, or you have to get pretty much, you have to go to the end within 12 hours, and it's kind of bullshit in that sense. I'll probably never do it because I'm not really good when it comes to speedrunning games. I mean, I'll try, but unless I know what I'm doing, there's just no point. I don't really want to deal with that. You might, I don't know. It's not my preference. Let's just put it that way. I think we can all agree. Preference makes up a whole lot of gameplay. And I have a certain way of doing things. It's not the best way, but, you know, it's how I like doing things. And, you know, I find it's very chill. I like enjoying my video games, but sometimes I'll rush through them. Not speed run wise, just like OCD, like exploration, check everything, and then, you know, kind of rush through the plot. That kind of rushing. Because, like, whenever it comes to exploration in any sort of game, I have to check everything. Because I don't know how the game's going to play until, like, the halfway point, then you get a good sense. But, you know, it's like Final Fantasy, like Final Fantasy 9, 7, I guess 8, which I'm not the biggest fan of 8, but I have my reasons. One, you know, if you've ever seen, like, the Spoony One's review of Final Fantasy 8, like, his classic review, you know, that probably explains a lot. I guess we're going old school if we're talking about that, but, you know, it's like, that kind of covers a lot of my feelings when it comes to 8, you know, it's not the best, there's a lot of things kind of wrong with it, but I will say this, when it comes to Final Fantasy 8, like, if I had to praise them for anything they did right, like, some of the music's pretty good, like, Man with a Machine Gun, or The Man with the Machine Gun, I don't remember, it's basically the battle theme whenever you control Laguna and the dream segments, that battle theme. I love that battle theme. I think that's a really cool battle theme. And I mean, there's other songs and tracks in the game that I think are really good. The action segments, whenever like you have something going on, I feel like those are really well done. Like, They're not the focus of 8, but whenever they do come up, I generally look forward to them. Hell, I look forward to the dream segments. I mean, I'm not saying Laguna is a great character, but I always enjoy whenever I do get to play with him. And partially because of his battle theme, you know, the man with the machine gun. That is a great track. Oh, man. I listen to that at work, because I can listen to music via MP3 player when I work. And so, you know, I listen to a lot of Final Fantasy tracks. And to be honest, music is a huge part whenever I play video games, so, you know, I cannot lie. I love video game OSTs. They're just great. Well, some of them. Not all of them. I can't lie. I've heard some pretty bad tracks. And, you know, sometimes it's not even that they're bad, they're just not memorable. I can say that about a lot of Final Fantasy XII's music. It's just, I don't know what it is. It's not bad. It's actually pretty good. It's very symphonic, but at the same time, it's just, I don't know. It's not my forte. It just doesn't really stick to mine. Then again, they do have some memorable tracks, because, I don't know, for some reason, whenever I play a game, it's like there's always that one track that just sticks out in comparison to the rest, and it might be the fact that, you know, if like nothing sticks out, there's always like that one tone that makes one song stick out more than the rest, and so it kind of carries over and you remember that song, or at least that's how I feel. But regardless of all that, I have to say Final Fantasy like 8 had some really good tracks that I'll even praise. I'll say that they're good. You know, it has some really good things. But it also has some really terrible things, like Eyes on Me. I mean, that's like the definitive theme of Final Fantasy VIII, and it's just, it's not that good. I can't get behind it. I'm sorry, the love plot in 8 just, it was bullshit. It just didn't really stick out. Hell, I was playing World of Final Fantasy and, you know, Renoa wasn't even in there. You figured she might have shown up or something, but nope. Then again, like, a lot of characters that you figure would show up in World of Final Fantasy did not show up, but I guess that's irrelevant. Maybe they'll make a sequel, add more things to it, or maybe, like, I hear there's gonna be DLC for that game, so, you know, maybe it'll just, like, they'll just keep adding DLC and it's just gonna equivalate to more and more characters. Something about anti-champions, which, you know, I'd be really curious. I figure they're talking about the villains. And I'm down with that, you know. I like the Final Fantasies. I think you got the idea, you know. It's like, I can go on. But, you know, it's like, even if I nerd out and just, like, go on about it, it's like, I guess I should talk about anything else, right? Well, I mean, like, 8. I was going on about 8. Like, so, 8 has some good things. 8 has some really bad things. One thing that I really don't like about 8, and this is probably very frivolous, it overshadowed one of my favorite games. And I don't really know how I can, I don't really know if that's like a valid reason for not liking 8, but it's like, I don't like it. Man, there's this game, it's called Legend of Legaia, and I want to let's play it at some point, but I'm still not quite sure how I'd tackle it. I'm still brainstorming on that one. It's your standard turn-based RPG, but, you know, I feel like it's really good. Like, the story's just kind of really, I don't want to say it's new. In fact, it's kind of cliched, but it's, like, kind of in an awesome way, you know? You know how sometimes, like, even though something's cliched, it's kind of awesome regardless, because it feels like it's done right. I feel like that game, they do a good job with how they just handle, like, the tone of everything. Hell, you even got a silent protagonist in that game, but at the same time, I really dig the shit out of it. The magic system is really cool. It's basically much in the fashion of, like, summoning in Final Fantasy and Pokemon, in the sense of how you get it. Basically, you capture the monsters. There's certain monsters you can capture in that game. And then you summon them in battle, and they level up, and they get better, and it's neat. I actually look forward to using magic, and I'm not a heavy magic user. I don't know why. I feel like whenever you get the basic standard attack, it's easier to use, and it's just straightforward. Use that as opposed to, like, magic, which, I don't know. You always have to, like, take an extra step just to, like, use it. Like in Skyrim, for instance, you always have to select it, but once it's select, I guess it's pretty straightforward. I don't know. I always like melee. I always like physical weapons and stuff like that, as opposed to magic. That's just my preference. I mean, after all, like the title says, Gildem Warrior. What am I? A warrior. I like hacking and slashing. I like swords. I like great swords. Great swords are my preference. Or actually, you know, double-handed weaponry is more of my preference. But great swords. I like great swords. They're pretty cool. They look neat. What can I say? If I was like in some sort of fantasy RPG realm and I actually had to use a weapon to fight monsters and stuff like that, because, you know, overactive imagination, so you think about these kind of things. It's like, I totally would use a great... I'd use greatsword, but chances are, if I was just, like, thrown into this situation, there's no way I'd be able to use a greatsword, because, you know, I'm not strong enough. It'd be like, all of a sudden, you're thrown into this world, and it's like, oh, man, you can have a greatsword, but I'm not strong enough to use it, so that's pointless. I'd have to go to, like, a one-handed sword and try to gain strength so I could actually move up to use one. And even then, it's like, you know, you're talking about a 28-year-old who's, like, done with all puberty and growth and stuff like that, so I have to, it takes even longer, and I have to work up the strength, and I have to lose the weight and stuff like that. It's bullshit. But you gotta do it, right? You gotta do it. Physical fitness. And life. Things that just feel like bullshit. I don't know. Speaking of which, I've been thinking about getting back into cardio, which sounds really funny. Talking about kind of a slightly overweight dude just trying to, like, get into cardio, which, it's not that I don't mind cardio. I used to do a little bit of it. It's just, I'm not the strongest runner. Although, once you do it for a little while, you kind of get used to it, and it's not that big of a deal. The difference is, you know, starting. I don't know. There's some things that are really hard to start. Like, it's kind of like, I'll get to it tomorrow. I feel like everyone's had those kind of things, you know. It's like, starting it is a pain. Sticking with it is kind of a pain. But once you actually get into the routine, it's not so bad. And that I think that's the problem, you know. It's like, I want to do cardio, but, you know, starting it is kind of really annoying. It's like flossing in a lot of ways. You know, it's not so bad once you're in the routine of doing it, but God help me, once you actually starting it, whew. I don't know about you, but my gums bleed, or at least they did. Then I started doing it. Now I'm in the routine of doing it, so it's not so bad. But at the same time, it's just, it's bullshit, man. Who wants to have their gums bleed, you know? And apparently, salt water, like rinsing your mouth out with salt water, I heard that helps. My dentist said it helps. So I'm taking it as advice on that. I have some credible information, or at least I think I do. I don't know. I just have to go on my word of my dentist. I don't know. It's weird. It's weird saying I have a dentist. It's weird. Hell. You know, the weirdest part about being an adult is if you have insurance, because, you know, to me, insurance equals adulthood, and that is, like, the weirdest thing, because, you know, as a kid, you don't, insurance is, like, nothing. It's like your parents, you know, it's like your parents have to do insurance and deal with all that stuff, and it I don't know, it always sounds kind of intimidating, because it's like a thing that helps you pay for a thing, which if you didn't have it, it'd be super expensive. Or that's how I equated it as a kid. But as an adult, it's like, I have insurance, so I don't have to worry so much, but at the same time, it's like, still need money to pay for anything that's not covered. Although a good chunk of it is covered, so I don't have to worry too much. It's just, insurance is weird, and it makes me feel old. And I feel like an adult every time I have to deal with anything that has to deal with insurance. Like medical, or dental, or vision. because, you know, I wear glasses, so I have to ensure that, you know, I have good vision, because, you know, I'm nearsighted. Which is weird, because, you know, it's like, I like my glasses. I'm used to my glasses. I've done contacts, and I don't mind contacts, but the problem with contacts is, like, you can't be lazy with them. And I'm a pretty lazy guy. Sure, they make me look, you know, prettier, because for some reason I'm a pretty dude, or at least that's what people tell me. I'm not handsome, I'm pretty. And it always makes me feel weird saying that, but, you know, whatever. I guess I can't really change the mind of this one guy who's my best friend in high school. And my friend and stuff, but I guess that's besides the point. that's completely irrelevant. What I'm saying is, you know, context, you know, they make me look pretty, but at the same time, you can't be lazy with them, and I like being lazy. I don't know about you, but being lazy is just the best. That's probably why I have trouble trying to get into the routine of doing cardio, because it kind of cuts into my gameplay time, but at the same time, it kind of allows me to have a better life in ways of, you know, I don't have to, like, have extra weight, which is apparently really bad for your knees, or at least that's what I've heard, you know. But, I really don't know where I'm going with this. Point is, what was this thing? Oh, yeah. Contacts, I can't be lazy with them, and that sucks. You know, I don't mind contacts. Yeah, at first, it was kind of a pain trying to figure out how to put these things in, because essentially, you know, you have your finger going towards your eye, and you can't really close your eye, even though that's, like, my initial instinct to just do that. Can't do that with contacts. As much as you wish you could, you can't. So it's kind of intimidating. It reminds me a lot of that one scene from Dead Space 2, specifically with the needle and the and trying to, like, stab it through your eye straight into your pupil. You know, it's just it makes you cringe. It's one of those things that just is super cringeworthy. Can't avoid, but at the same time, it's just like, oh god, how am I supposed to deal with this? Of course, once you're used to it, you understand it's really not that big of a deal. All you gotta do is just, like, you know, part your eyelid and then just put it in, and then it's in, and then, you know, take it out every couple of hours, like, to rehydrate your eyes with some of that solution and stuff like that, because they got that contact lens solution that helps rehydrate your eyes, and then you got eye drops, and you do that, and it helps, and then you put the contact back in, and then, you know, you're good to go for another couple hours. That said, never fall asleep with your contacts. I've never done it, but I've heard plenty of stories why you never want to do it. They're all horrific and cringeworthy. Anyways, what was I saying? Oh yeah, can't be lazy with contacts, and that's pretty much why. Glasses, on the other hand, hell, you can fall asleep with your glasses. It's not that big of a deal. Unless you somehow crush them, but I've yet to actually do that. So, you know, it's like, I can be lazy with my glasses, and it's not that big of a deal. Hell, this isn't even my good pair. I have two pairs. One's a good pair. This is my, like, every other situation pair. So, you know, I can be as lazy as I want with glasses, and I like it like that. Besides, it's not like I'm trying to impress anyone. It's not like high school, where it's like all that stuff counts and you're trying to impress this one chick that you have a major crush on, and it's like, it's leading nowhere because you're gutless and you're like, oh man, I'll never gain her attention. Because that happened to me. And now I live with regret, sort of. I don't know. Life is what it is. Live and learn, right? And regret. But don't think too much on the regret, because, like, there's, I don't know, regret is really pointless. It's just something that you reflect back, and it's like, oh man, I wish I could have done that differently back in the day. And it's like, yeah, I wish I could have, but, you know, it's like, what would that have changed? Like, a question in my mind? Probably, but otherwise, it's like, regret is, like, super pointless. So at the same time, even though I wish I could have done it differently, I guess it's pointless thinking about it now. So, no regrets. No regrets. Even though I could have done things differently, you know, I'm okay with who I am now. So it's like, even though there may be regret, I shouldn't. Because if I did do something about it, I wouldn't turn out the way I am. And I like the way I am. Because, you know, I do stuff for the YouTubes, and I enjoy doing stuff for the YouTubes. This is a great hobby. And I'll say that over and over again, because, you know, I really do enjoy that. Hell, this is why I'm trying to, like, mix it up and do, like, projects like this, so it's, like, super easy, super just, like, laid back. Hell, this is really chill. I like this. I like this experiment. It might not make any sense to you, but hell, I'm just gonna keep on doing it until everyone's like, oh man, I'm on that weird part of YouTube again. And you know, I hope someone says that. It's so cliched that I hope it happens. I feel like anyone gets some sort of cliched comment eventually. Anyone who like actually earns their place on YouTube, you know, has got one of those cliched comments, you know, the kind of comments that that you see on YouTube, the kind of comments that are like the top 10 YouTube comments that you'll find here on in the comment section of YouTube on channels and stuff like that. I feel like anyone who's like earned their place here on YouTube has gotten one of those. I have not, so I gotta work my way. I gotta earn my place, you know. 6 years and I still haven't gotten anything. Well, except for friends. I've gotten friends. Friends are pretty cool. I have some really cool friends that I've met here. I cannot deny the fact that I've met some really cool people. But other than that, you know, it's like, I haven't gotten any of the cliche comments. I still need one. Anybody watching, give me a cliche comment. I don't even care if it makes sense. I don't even care if it doesn't make sense. I would prefer I'm on that weird part of YouTube. Damn it. Now I'm thinking on the spot, and I can't think on the spot. I'm terrible when it comes to that. Because I was going to list a second one, but I don't even know. Oh, first. Yeah, of course. Someone wants to be, like, first, and then after that, second. You know, that I would accept that, too. Actually, I take that back. You know, maybe I have gotten one of those. In which case, I guess I've earned my place. So I guess I just lied. I guess what my whole thing is just, I don't even know anymore. I don't even know who I am. I guess it doesn't matter. Point is, first, second, whatever. I don't care. Point is, I'm happy with who I am. No regrets. I like glasses. Final Fantasy. God. See, this is why I ramble. This is why I need to ramble. Just because it's like, I have all these thoughts, and it's like, how else am I going to get them off my chest? Go to counseling? You know how much counseling costs? Well, nothing if you have insurance. Apparently, that's what I found out. Because I have insurance, it costs nothing for, like, several visits. And then it's, like, $60. And that's bullshit. Because, you know, the counselor, he's like, oh, yeah, you know, it's like, how about we schedule an appointment for next week? And it's like, I don't... $60, man. Think about that. $60 a week. That doesn't sound bad, but in a month's time, which is about, like, 4 or 5 weeks, we're talking that's, like, what? $300. I don't want to spend $300 a month. That's like way too much. You know what I could get for $300? A PS4, an Xbox One, like enough games for half a year. No, I could probably like just like save up for like 2 months and do stuff. So it's like F that. You know, I'll just make a video. This is therapeutic, in my opinion. This is better than any counseling session. It's hell. You know, when I'm not gonna lie. I used to do counseling because I have issues. I have mental issues. Not anything serious. Just like I don't know. I overthink a lot of things sometimes. I'm not saying like I'm crazy or like I have any sort of mental disorder. I'm just saying like Whoa, where was I going with this? It just got super awkward, right? No, it's just like I just have like a lot of thoughts that sometimes I need to vent. Yeah, that's a good way of putting what I wanted to say. Sometimes I need to vent because, all this shit, it builds up, and you don't want it to build up because, everyone has their own problems, and when you let problems just stack onto another problem, then all of a sudden you're just in a pile of shit, and it's like, oh man, I dug myself a hole. How do I get out of this hole? So, venting is kind of good. Making these parts are super chill and super relaxed, and I can talk about anything. And the best part is, I don't think anyone's watching. Although, someone might be. I got a comment on the last part. Not saying that, like, I don't like comments or anything like that. No, please leave a comment. Watch my shit. I don't even care. Don't watch my shit. It really doesn't make any difference to me, in the sense that like people will do what they want. Hopefully, I make something entertaining, and you guys are like, "Oh man, Gildem. He's gone into that weird part of his brain, and he's just rambling on about anything in life." And his problems, inventing like ideas, they don't even make sense. And it's like, yeah, I do that. I do that because, like, if I don't, my issues, my problems, my thoughts, because, I guess my thoughts aren't really issues or problems, they're just anything that I think about, and they all just build up and they stack up on each other, and then all of a sudden it's just like, man, what am I gonna do? I mean, I guess I could be one of those weird people that talks, that's like stands out on the street corner and talks about how the world's ending, but I don't want to be that guy. No one wants to be that guy except for the guy that's standing on the corner yelling that the world's gonna end. I don't know. I'm not very good at trying to phrase. I'm not very good at trying to phrase my words. Just talk about anything that I really want to talk about. I try to at times, but it doesn't work out. Not in the slightest. It's like I'll just ramble incoherently and try to hope that someone's like, okay. Nice talking to you. Man, I really hope I'd never have to listen to Gildem talk about his stuff. But it's like, I don't care. I'm gonna talk about my stuff. Cause it makes me feel better. And so like, you guys if you want to help me feel better, it's like, honestly, you're doing it. You're listening to me. And it's not like I have any problems or anything. Like I said, this is just me, like, ventilating thoughts and stuff. I don't know why I'm held up on this thing. I guess I'm trying to explain something, and it's like, you did that, Gildem. You can move on to the next topic. Except I can't. Because, the video's, like, pretty much over. I just finished the second day in this Pikmin thing, and I figure, like, that's a good 30 minutes right there. 30 minutes of me talking about whatever, so, it's like, I don't know. Next week, maybe. Or next time. Yeah, next time's probably better, because I don't know if I'm doing this weekly or whatnot. It's not like it matters. But yeah, it's just like me chilling with you guys and just talking and just having Pikmin play and I do things. But I don't know. What's the point? what matters is like, thank you for listening to me. That's what matters to me. You listening to me and me feeling like I did something. And so, yeah, alright, I guess this is over. I'm gonna go play Skyrim or something. Okay, bye.